So here's what you missed on BSU Tonight. Megan became the first female host of the show, and it was a big deal. Then it was homecoming, and some weird BSU students came on the show. Halloween was next and was super spooky. Megan also tried to give thanks for Thanksgiving, and sea salt and cinnamon helped her make a vegan pie. Carl Doninger took over the show and held Megan captive to promote PopCon. Christmas happened, and Megan killed an elf on the shelf. Studio A got flooded, so we got kicked out, but luckily we had a show at CCIM Super Party, so everything was okay. Last time we had fairy tales take over the show, and it was insane! And that's what you missed on BSU Tonight!
Exciting episode. Got a lot of great stuff that our writers have written for this episode, including an educational bit about transforming your old pickles into usable cucumbers.
Did somebody say a highly choreographed musical number?
No, Greg. I was talking about cucumbers.
Oh, okay. Well, we'll be around.
Okay. Let's start with the package.
Now, Earth was formless and empty. Darkness was all over the surface and the deep. And the Spirit of God was hovering over the waters. And God said,
break time! You know what that means!
Post-Bible study rap battle!
A one, a two, a skiddly-diddly-do!
My name is Jane and I'm with my pals, catching up on some fighting crime morals. Always trusted and by my side. If Sam and Beth leave me, I think I might die.
Oh, Bible flow.
You sounded so much more confident that time.
Yeah, echoing what Beth said, your flow was great. However, using more Christ-like imagery might pack a bigger punch.
Heard. All right, Sam, your turn.
A one, a two, a skiddly-diddly-do.
Yo, my name is Sam, and I'm a lamb. Bah-bah, black sheep, I'm a ram. Girls hunt me down like I'm their kill. The one I want to catch me is Beth's mom, Jill.
Yes!
Wait, what? Dude?
What? It was a joke. Come on, it's funny.
Just because it's funny does not mean you should say it.
Your flow was choppy, too.
You think you can do better?
Hit it.
A one. A two, a skiddly diddly do.
Best the name, education's the game. I study all the time just to bust your buster rhyme. Flow so fresh that I'm never gonna trip. Wit so quick, my tongue cracks like a whip.
Woo! Nice!
Yeah, I don't get it.
What do you mean?
My tongue cracks like a whip? Seriously, dude? No human tongue can actually do that.
You know, the comment about my mom was one thing, but these bars?
Well, maybe if you put more time into your rhymes, they'd make more sense.
Oh, you're just mad that you didn't come up with it.
Would you take that back?
Sam! Better?
better.
You're not you when you're hungry.
Welcome back. My next guest coming out is, oh God, please help us. Daddy Derek and Lollipop Lee, the Two Pumps. Yeah. Welcome back. Welcome back, guys.
Thank you so much, Margaret. Thank you so much. Hi, ladies and gentlemen. My name's Daddy Derek.
And I'm Lollipop Lee.
And we want to thank you for letting us back on the show.
It's so good to see all your cute little faces, and it's good to see you boys and girls at home, too.
So we came back on the show because our message is nowhere near done. We have so many more songs to teach you kids and you pesky little adults, too. Isn't that right? All right, Lee, do you have trouble keeping your hands to yourself sometimes?
All the time, Daddy Derek. I just get so jittery, and I just can't stop touching things. This song is about keeping your hands to yourself.
Get away from the cat. Get away from the cat. It will scratch your eye. You'll want to die. Please stop walking towards the cat. Please stop walking towards the cat. It's a pussycat, but I don't mean you go snooping around. It's a female, I assure you, so please put it down. Don't touch the dog's nasty penis. Don't touch the dog's nasty penis. It's purple, deformed. It's purple, a worm. Please step away from the dog. Please step away from the dog. I'm concerned for your mental health. Do animals get you? If so, make sure you get help soon. Very nice, very nice. That was beautiful.
So good, so good.
What a blessing, what a blessing.
It's kind of catchy. What's up with the subject matter?
Thank you for your feedback, Maxwell.
Yes, so this next song aims to educate children in the field of literature.
Literature, oh no.
Oh no is right, that pesky literature goes sneak up on you, isn't it? But we have a song about certain types of words that share the same sound but mean something different.
You mean like homonymonyms?
No, Lee, I'm not talking about homonymonyms. I'm talking about the words they don't teach you at school. These are the double meaning words they don't tell you about in the education system.
Okay.
Words can have more than one meaning. Red is the color, past tense of reading. Similar words can be confusing. So watch out for the words you're using. Cause daddy don't mean no father when you're older. Cause daddy don't mean no father when you're older. Fathers are fathers. Daddy is someone else, so don't get lost. Don't get lost in the double, 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 double entendre. The right to bear arms or bear right. Or I could be talking about an animal that bites. English is tough, too many meanings. Watch yourself, you could be talking about your weenie. Cause daddy don't mean no father when you're older. Cause daddy don't mean no father when you're older. Donkeys are donkeys. Asses are, they're still donkeys, but it means something else. So don't get lost. Don't get stuck in the double, 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 double entendre. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome
Little Nasty!
Juice!
Talking double entendres with two pumps. If you want some Coke, is it a pop or a bump?
Yeah.
It can get pretty tricky, but don't get stumped. If my dog wants a bone, it might want to hump. Here's some advice that you can take from me. Be careful when you ask for a bag of tea.
Whoa.
Wiener, 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 but what could it be? A dog or a penis? Just wait and see.
Woo!
Double, double, double. Double, double, double. Double. Double, 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 double entendre.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. We love you so
much. Yeah. I just got social media under
the two pumps. Thank you.
Thank you.
Did someone say highly choreographed musical number?
No one said that. What's going on with you guys?
We're just keeping an eye out. See you around.
Wow, you're strange, those two. Okay, let's get to a package before they come back.
I told you to wait till it cools down.
I know, but hey, I like it hot. It's not real unless, right?
Hey, did you remember to tip the pizza guy?
I thought you tipped him.
Jack!
I know.
You know how my family feels about people who don't tip.
More like can't tip. Your dad does realize that most of the kids around here can barely afford to pay tuition, let alone for breadsticks, right? All right, I'll stop by the shop and pay whatever's left.
Who knows? Maybe you'll finally get around to giving you that job he offered.
Like that'd happen. Next time.
Thank you.
Hearts will play tippy tippy tay, tippy tippy tay, like a guitar and then.
Welcome back. On this musical episode, we have a fun new game that is completely original to our show that we like to call the Veiled Vocalist. It's simple. We placed one mystery performer in a disguise that covers their face. They'll perform a song for us, and then myself and our two judges will try and guess who they really are underneath. Here to help me, please give a warm welcome to our two judges all the way from the Hargreaves Music Building. Give it up for music professors Humphrey Altone and Tina Kirkland. And now, for our Veiled Vocalist, put your hands together for the Emperor. Welcome to our show. Are you ready to sing for us?
Sure am, kiddo. yeah, let's do this.
Dad?
What? No. Guess again, I'm not. Dad? Who's Dad?
I'm stumped. He's got a great vocal disguise.
Or she. We don't know yet.
That's right.
No? No, we do. That's my dad. That's my... He's under the mask.
But you never know.
No, I'm actually 100% certain that's my dad. Why are you questioning me on this?
Oh, they're starting.
Having so much to say. Watching you walk away. My
man. Okay, very funny, Dad. Glad you came on the show just to surprise me.
But that's what I was trying to say.
This one's a stumper. I think that might be President Mearns? Yeah, it's definitely President Mearns.
No, I know my dad's voice, guys. You can stop, I mean.
Sandra Bullock. I'm positive it's Sandra Bullock. It sounds just like her.
Just like her.
What? That's a man, and that man is my father. What? How could we possibly afford to get her on our show?
I think it's too early to call, honestly.
I agree. You know what? All right, Emperor, it's time for you to unveil yourself and show us who you really are.
Unveil, 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 unveil.
Oh, this is ridiculous. Dad, what are you doing here?
Well, honey, I just... Your mother and I miss you very much.
Okay, yeah.
You're so busy hosting and playing with your dog, and you don't have time to come back to us. We miss you. We really miss you.
Yeah, of course, Dad. You know, it's just a college TV show, and, you know, if you wanted me to come home, you could have just called, maybe texted.
I just...
Yeah.
We love you so much, Megan. Please come home, please.
Oh, okay. Shh, don't cry. Hey. Oh, for God's sake. If you stop crying, we can get dinner together as a father and daughter dinner.
That sounds nice. So, Puertas?
Puertas.
Let's go to Puertas.
Puertas. It's Guatemala. All right, Dad. Can we stand off to the side?
Okay.
We're gonna move on now.
All right.
Give it up for my dad, everyone. Okay. Let's cut to a package. How about that? Yeah.
Been through some bad shit, not to my advantage. Who would have thought it turned into a package? Rather be tied up with cords and not strings. Like what I write, like I write what I sing, yeah.
From the creators of Nicky Nick and the Slicky Dicks comes...
She said, do you love me? I tell her only partly. I only love my goose and my Megan. I'm sorry.
Now that's what I call BSU Tonight. Fans, get ready for an epic mashup of the two things you love most. Music, and BSU Tonight in this 30-song album.
We are so excited to bring you this awesome project that we've been working on for months. Hopefully our fans will see the amount of dedication we've put into this.
I'm pretty happy with what we've come up with so far. It's pretty wavy, you know? Especially our producer. He's the best in the game.
You know, I didn't really know what the project was until I got involved. And,
You know, it needs to have more of a drop, like the one in sicko mode. You know what I'm talking about? Like the bwah, bwah.
Yes, I've heard of sicko mode before.
But remember to give it its own flair. That's the whole point of this project, you know? It's not your average run-of-the-mill sicko mode. It's nicko mode. It's special to us, you know?
So, you want me to make sicko mode?
It's nicko mode. Can't you get it through your thick skull that this is not a ripoff? You know, I really don't think you're vibing with my vision.
I don't know how much longer I can do this.
Yeah, everyone had a lot of fun putting this together. I'm sure gonna remember the good times we had together.
Gone Arnie with the B-roll. Young Nicky here, nickel mode.
Where's the rest of it? Harrison? Harrison!
Now that's what I call BSU Tonight. 29 songs with a twist on the tunes you know and love.
Hello, and welcome back. We have with us...
Davon Shoemaker.
Griffin Sciarra.
These are comedians. Very exciting, I know. So, how long have you guys been doing comedy?
I've been doing comedy for about 3 years, almost four.
6 months.
Wow, newbie, that's exciting. How do you feel about that?
Yeah, I'm very green. You just gotta keep getting stage time and
get
on, and then one day you get lucky and you're on BSU Tonight.
Yeah.
That's what we call crowd pandering.
I know that quite well, actually. So what do you guys do in your real lives outside of comedy?
I'm a parent, so I do that.
That's like a real job.
No one in here knows that pain, so enjoy it while it lasts.
Yeah, Devon and I's daughter is very sweet. and I go to Ball State.
Okay, so... So comedy is a hobby for you guys? Is it something you want to pursue career-wise?
I would say it's a passion.
Passion.
You know, it's nothing that happens overnight, so it's going to take a long time, and it takes a lot of years.
Yeah.
Yeah, for me, it's comedy or journalism, so either way, I want to be poor. no, but it's just something that I'm very lazy by nature, and I figured a job where you get to just talk into a microphone would be ideal.
Yeah. No, I get it.
I'm sure you do.
And free drinks at bars don't hurt, you know?
Yeah, I could see that. So you guys obviously have done shows before. Do you have any interesting stories? Anything fun happened to you?
This is my first one. Nah, I'm kidding.
I was like, wait, how did you get here?
So I run Comedy Underground here at Be Here Now in Ball State. So there is a lot of good stories. I think Halloween this past year, we had a dance-off on stage, and a comedian ran around the whole bar. So that's probably the strangest stand-up story I've had.
Yeah, I'd have to say so.
I want to talk. Come on, this is my
time
to shine.
No. I was going to lead into that. Go ahead.
I was doing this show at a bar. I'm not 21. Hope you guys aren't narcs. No, I was doing the show at a bar. There were two people at the bar, and one of them was paying attention. And I opened with this really dad joke. I said, my girlfriend and I recently got a dog. We're trying to train her, you know, housebreaker, but it's tough because she hates it when I use the shock collar. She always says stuff like, get this thing off me, it's for the dog.
Yeah.
It's a really dumb joke. And I said that, and the one person listening, this older lady, said, now. And that's how the whole show went.
And you still can after that? You still did comedy after that?
Oh, yeah. I mean, you got to get love somewhere, right?
Yeah. Okay. So where is your favorite place to perform?
I don't know if I have a favorite place to perform. BSU Tonight.
How about that? Thank you.
I taught him that.
I learned quick.
No, my favorite place to perform is this place called Kettle Top in Anderson. It's a brewer, a bar. Yeah, just I'm also not 21, but yeah, it's a fun place to perform. A good crowd and like this crowd.
Good. Okay. So you guys talked about this a little bit, but do you guys have any like aspirations in comedy? Is there like a place like ideal, like I'd love to perform here, or like this is how I know I've peaked as a comedian?
I think I just recently peaked. I'm on BSU Tonight, so I think this does it. I might as well end it right now.
This is your peak?
I think it is. I think
I'm excited for you.
Oh, thanks. I appreciate that.
I'm thinking like a strip club.
Oh,
would be cool.
That would be a really unique performance.
Right,
Chippendales, right?
Never heard of that place.
Okay, you guys are really young.
Remember,
I apologize.
He's under 21.
Oh, okay, yeah, sorry. Yeah. Sorry about that.
All right. My mom's watching. Come on.
So where do you guys get inspiration for writing your jokes, for writing a set?
I'd say life.
Life.
For the most part, yeah. That's the best way to go about it, yeah.
Yeah, whenever a terrible situation happens, it comes from anger. Like, so when someone says something, I just want to punch him in the face, I just put him in my act.
That's good.
And make
that's
fun of them there. Because I'm not strong enough to make fun of them with their face.
No, I'm going to have to think about that next time I'm really angry. Try and make it funny. Right? Is that how that works? Well, you guys are in luck because we actually have some footage of these guys doing some comedy. So go ahead and check that out.
Hey, hey, how's everybody doing? I don't actually care. I just never know how to start this. I would like to point out I'm rocking this first one unbuttoned, and I've got this haircut. That way, you don't have to wonder if I'm a douchebag. Cut the guesswork out for you.
Are we all on Instagram in here? Yeah? Yeah, we're all IG'ing it. Yeah, we're young. So I think I hate Instagram now, because everyone's like living their best life on Instagram, you know? They're posting their newborn photos. They're posting their vacations, they're posting their perfect relationships, and I just spent my last $40 on the 8th, so my priorities are a little messed up.
No, I'm mostly just a weird guy, like, I took a bubble bath today. I love the baths, you know, they remind me of my childhood. I remember 3-4 years old, my parents would make me go on play dates with their friends' kids, and that's the worst, you know, because you barely know them, you barely like them, at the end of the day, you're taking a bath together. I think baths then are like group texts today, you know? Because if someone puts you in one with people you've never met, you're gonna cry.
I think I support Donald Trump now. You know, because he could just get away with the real stuff that Obama couldn't during his administration. For example, you know, a few months ago when he had that peace conference with Kim Jong-un, I could just appreciate that we can just sun countries like we couldn't, like we can just get it all out in the open. Like, it was a picture of him with Donald Trump with his hand on Kim Jong-un's shoulder. And the only thing I could think of was Jay-Z and Nas at Summer Jam. I thought this audience might be too young for that reference, so I appreciate that.
Yeah, parents always making me do stuff to make me weird. Like, in grade school, I learned to play the saxophone. Yeah, and that's an odd beast, the saxophone, you know? Because, like, if you're at a party and you bring out your guitar, you're the cool guy. But if you whip out a saxophone, you were not invited. I don't want you to get the wrong idea. My parents always knew how to comfort me. Like, I remember one time I was feeling insecure. I said, Mom, I'm doomed to look like Mr. Clean because Dad's bald, Grandpa's bald, even Great-Granddad is bald. But she said, Honey, you should not worry about that because looks are not everything, and I don't know who your real father is. Just jokes. Sorry, Mom.
I think being a black nerd as myself, one thing that I can just truly support with the Trump administration is Space Force, you know, because I always wanted to be the black Han Solo growing up, you know, having a human-sized pit bull as a best friend is definitely on my checklist.
I'm, as we speak, I'm picturing every single one of you in your underwear. I'm not nervous, just a creep.
I am a father, so we can applaud for it. I have a one-year-old daughter at home, so anytime my baby mother is going at me, being a young, black, handsome man that I am, only thing that I can tell her is, like, because she says, hey, why don't you buy more diapers? Or, hey, we need more formula. Or, hey, why do you follow so many big booty models on Instagram? I tell her, I'm out here fighting statistics, and I don't have time for that.
Now, I think language is so weird today. Like today, if you correct someone's spelling, you're a grammar Nazi. You know? That apostrophe you added to correct your stupid friend's use of the word your makes you comparable to the Third Reich. And that concerns me. Like me, I'm a breast stickler, you know? Symmetry's important to me. Does that mean in a few decades I'll be a terrorist?
I don't think anybody in this room else has kids, but my daughter is 1 year old, so she's teething right now, so I don't get much sleep. So like 3 o'clock in the morning, when I have to work and I'm looking at my beautiful daughter's face and she's bright red, the only thing that I can think of is, what's the 2019 version of going to get a pack of cigarettes and not coming back? You know.
No, it's just the way we talk to each other, though. Like my ex told me I look best with long hair, a beard, and sunglasses. I look best with 2/3 of my face covered. That'd be like if I told her she looked best with a Snapchat filter. Now, can you imagine we're out to dinner? Babe, this night has been amazing. It's just missing one thing. Let me just, that's much better. Stick your tongue out. Stick your tongue out. I love the dog filter on you.
I had a strange growing up, you know. My parents were hard workers. Like, my mom, she worked at a bank for a number of years. My dad had a number of jobs, actually. He cut grass during the summer. He fixed heating and cooling year-round. And he sold crack since 1989. So Christmas was kind of lit. This was the 90s, guys.
We're getting close to summertime. I know there's snow on the ground, but I need to lock down that summer job, that elusive summer job. And let me tell you, dress for the job you want is terrible advice when you want to be a porn star. People at the career fair are disgusted.
Do you have any Harry Potter fans? This is my last joke here. Yeah. I went to the Pottermore website, you know, because I want to know what my Patronus is, you know. It's going to be a rabbit, a stag, you know. Actually, it is a human-sized pit bull, so I'm going to go ahead and knock that off the checklist. I do have a theory with Harry Potter, though. I do believe he's the realest thug ever because he literally stops snitches.
No, I don't know. I do go to Ball State. Study journalism. Not as big of an applause for that. Now, because people, when you say that, people look at you like you intern at the Death Star. Truthful storytelling only here. A couple of weeks ago, I was interviewing this guy for a story. He cut me off mid-question. He said, I'm sorry if this is unprofessional, but I have to tell you, your eyes are... He acted out an emoji to compliment my eyes. No woman has ever complimented my eyes in my entire life. Not even a haphazard, like, oh, that sure makes your eyes pop. Nothing. My own mother, whose eyes I have. Nothing. Hey, I'm out of time. You guys have been awesome. Thank you very much.
Thank you. My name is Davon Shoemaker.
How you been?
Yeah, I actually I have a part-time job now, so I'm living above the poverty line.
Yeah, dude, me too, man. Oh, school, baby! Oh, dude, I got a part-time job too. It's been crazy, man. I don't have to wear this thing anymore. Like, I can get new clothes. It's great.
Yeah, I've been stockpiling ramen noodles for when I get fired in the future, so that's pretty good.
Ah, I feel that. Yeah, man, ramen noodles. I can't wait to try them now that I can afford them. It's like
It's like I'm
noodle rich. You know what this means?
Yes, I do.
We gotta hit the studio. Well, I mean.
I mean,
we can go to Fazoli's after we're done making.
No, yeah, song. yeah. We gotta hit it up.
Harry, bless this beat.
It's Nikki Noodle Rich.
I ain't got no problems cause I'm noodle rich. I can get McDonald's with my crew is sick. Got a savings account cause I'm too legit. I ain't got no problems cause I'm noodle rich.
I'm the big boss, I'm the next crook. Used to sell my prescriptions to buy textbooks. Great value milk and my toaster strudel. I got friends, I got love, and I got the noodles. We both got jobs, now our wallet's popping.
Nikki's working part-time at a Baskin Robbins.
Peach works as an Uber, let him give you a ride.
Only two of my passengers have mysteriously died. I'm cozy and warm, AC on lock. Got a roof over my head instead of a box. I'm lounging around in my new fleece socks. Chilling with my new girl instead of a box.
Got noodles in your cabinet, I'm nabbing it.
Nah.
I love noodles, give me noodles, it's my having it.
You know I'm longing for the ramen, any other is inadequate. Bring ramen with my brothers like a holy noodle sacrament.
I ain't got no problems cause I'm noodle rich. I can get McDonald's with my crew is lit. Got a savings account cause I'm too legit. I ain't got no problems cause I'm noodle rich.
Yo.
Are you Nikki Mick and Professor Peach?
Oh, yeah.
You've just been served.
Oh, no.
You're being sued.
Oh, okay. That makes sense.
Turns out there's a company called Noodle Rich, and it's owned by a man named Noodle Rich, saying that his trademark has been infringed.
So now I'm gonna take your ass to court, make you my noodle.
Everybody quiet down, court is now in session. We're here to decide on Noodle Rich's possession. Jurors, I hope you get the evidence you need. The plaintiff goes first, Noodle Rich, you may proceed.
Your Honor, these boys have no respect for my brand. They tarnish my name, so that's why I demand $20,000 in punitive damages. If I had it my way, you can't get both the advantages!
Hey, order!
I will not have this in my courtroom. Defense attorney! Your time begins now. Let's hear it.
20 grand, man, you don't understand. We got 100 bands, mostly rubber bands.
They're suing us because we're rapping about snacks. If it pleases the court, let us present the facts. We combined our noggins in some media law and found out that your claim is an immediate flaw.
Your trademark expired back in 2003. Got it registered for us.
Now Noodle Rich is me.
We ain't got no problems, now we're Noodle Rich. A picture comes up if you Google it. We won this lawsuit cause we're too legit. We ain't got no problems, now we're Noodle Rich. I ain't got no problems when I'm Noodle Rich. I can get McDonald's with my crew is lit. Got a savings account cause I'm too legit. I ain't got no problems cause I'm Noodle Rich.
Dismiss you! I do!
You're dismissed.
Wow, that was good. So thank you all for coming out to BSU tonight. We've had a really great episode.
Hey,
very musical. Oh, yeah.
Have you seen Megan Gregg lately?
Yeah, actually, I have. Yeah, I was just about to wrap up, and they've been acting so weird. They keep saying, like, did somebody say highly choreographed musical number? And I don't, it's really getting old.
Did somebody say highly choreographed musical number?
I did, oh no. You can run, run.
Okay, get ready. Okay. Hit it!
Good.
Hit it!
Thank you all for watching tonight. We hope you all had a really good time here at BSU Tonight. It's our
show that has a highly choreographed musical number. And thank you to the comedians, Davon and Griffin. Thank you guys so much for coming out.